So it is Wednesday evening, guys. It's March 11th. It's 11:03 p.m. I usually don't like working out this late, but it is what it is. Got a busy work schedule, so gotta fit it in when I can.
And tomorrow we have a Fit for a King concert.
Yes.
We will be filming as much as we
another
can.
Another concert vlog. So this video will be, I don't know how long this is going to go, open up just kind of raw and personal about some stuff. Most of you guys, if you watched my last video, you guys got to see that while the Arnold Expo got canceled due to all the coronavirus hysteria, I was still able to go and meet up with like some of the biggest people I look up to in lifting. Like, got to meet Sawyer Clott, Lex Little, James English, Oliver Forslund, Zach Jennings, a few other people. I just had a really, really awesome time, but it's just been like, that was this past Saturday, and that was like just such a overwhelming experience, but it's like really given me a burst of motivation. I know like staying like true to your goals or accomplishing what you want to get done in life with lifting or whatever it is, it's not just about having motivation, it's about having discipline and staying on track, but you do go through times where you need that burst of motivation. So, and like that's where I'm at right now, and being able like just to interact with like all of them, super awesome guys, super awesome people, very down to earth. I think a lot of people get a bad impression of them, that they're like they're douchebags or they're full of themselves or whatever. Like, that literally could not be fucking farther from the truth.
Which at some
all.
Of them are, but at all. With our like, experience, most have been. Most
I don't
of
like
them
maybe
have
they are
awesome.
To some people. I don't know, but I know that with my experience, talking to them, hanging out with, like, I was literally like hanging out with them like a regular person, and that was like I, like literally did not expect that at all.
Right.
And I think it was so awesome that I had the chance to be able to do that, in that environment. And then it wasn't just like at an expo where I'm waiting 2 hours in line to see somebody for 5 seconds and a kind of just a superficial exchange of, oh, hey, how's it going?
Right,
high five.
Like I said
hey,
in my
snap
last...
snap a picture and you're gone. You know what I mean? Like, I actually got to talk for a few minutes one-on-one. You
right.
know what I say?
Right, like I said in my last video where I was talking in Wendy's parking lot, I was basically saying that it was, I felt, had a feeling it was a blessing in disguise because they were doing these meetups and... What do you know, here we are, me and Asher, posing with Sawyer Clott, man,
yeah.
and Yucky Lovato, man.
Yeah.
I mean, to a degree, it's like, it's so overwhelming and it's so crazy, but by the time me and Asher left, like, we kind of felt like we were already sponsored athletes, that these people were our friends, and we've just had conversations with them, like that whole
And we're not saying
start,
that, we're not saying that in an arrogant way. Like,
right, yeah, like,
not, we know how much farther we got to go. Even just with,
but that part of being like starstruck and stuff, it kind of wore off, but in a good way, to the point where
yeah.
we were just kind of talking to him, and we were like,
yeah.
"Hey, these are just regular
I literally
people."
Like sat and talked with Sawyer like one on one for probably a good 10 minutes. Like just
yeah.
just me and him, we were just talking to him, and I was asking him, you know, like how's because Sawyer says he trains 7 days a week, and we were just kind of talking to him for a minute, like how you know he deals with that, like with his CNS, and he was. Like, talking to us about, like, how when he grew up, like, he had issues, like, growing, like, imbalances. And,
right.
like, his back and, like, bones would pop out of place and, like...
Which, speaking of that, like, injuries
his back
and
was
stuff.
All fucked up and, like, now his back is his strong suit and,
Which, speaking of, like, injuries and stuff, me and Asher kind of have the same goal as where we want to go and the end goal and everything. But right now we're kind of working a little bit separately just because he's at a good stage in his... And his workouts right now to where he can program himself and he's ready to like, you know, grind and start getting strong as hell. Whereas I am too, but my hip has been absolutely destroyed right now and I can't even squat. And like, basically I'm going to work in with him as much as possible, but I'm going to have to kind of develop my own little program. On top of that, I have to find the positive in things. And if you've watched any of our recent videos, mostly mine, but his too, I bend my wrist a lot on the bench. And, you know, I'm sacrificing my form on squats. So I'm going to make sure when I can squat again, I'm going to focus on my form a lot more. And right now I'm going to focus on not bending my wrist. That way I at least get better and improve in some way. But this is his, video, so I'm gonna get him, man. Let him talk.
So I just kind of in line with that, but like also like, I just think like meeting with these guys, like I think James is a little bit older than me. I think he's 20, but yeah. Like Sawyer and Lex, like Oliver as well. Like these guys are like, just a little bit younger than me, and like they're just like with their lifts and their physiques, like they're doing so crazy. And like, I haven't shared a whole lot about myself at all, on the channel. I won't get into it too much in this video. That would be too long, but, I'm 19 now, about 19 and a half. I'm going to turn 20 this August. And I just had a lot of stuff that I've been through growing up as a teenager. And then I moved out of my parents' house when I turned 18, and it forced me to mature very quickly, and I've been through a ton of shit, and like just having to kind of do like not really be able to live like my life as a teenager. Like, I had to grow up very fast, and so now like I've, you know, I gotta do all these kind of adult things, but still I need to not let those responsibilities keep me from achieving my goals, like still like hitting the gym with 110% intensity, okay, even if I have been working 9-10 hour days, you know what I mean, or I'm stressed out, or I haven't ate enough, or whatever it is, like, not letting those excuses drag me down, because they're bullshit. And, like, when I get in the zone, like, my mentality, like, my motivation, my discipline, like, I know it's unmatched, and I just see, like, where my own self, like, where I've slacked off in that. And so, I'm hoping to show you guys, like, in these next upcoming weeks and months, like, just what the fuck I'm capable of. I really want to get back to a mindset of where, like, I'm so zoned in and obsessed, like, literally nothing is going to fucking stop me from getting to where the fuck I want to be. Whether it be sponsored by Gymshark, or sponsored by Alphalete, or whatever it is, competing in a bodybuilding show, sure, breaking records in powerlifting, like whatever it is, like that's the level I want to be on. I don't want to just be a gym bro who makes YouTube videos and has some pretty good lifts, you know what I mean. I want to be at an elite level. I want to be the best that I can I'm like getting emotional. I want to be at the best level I can possibly fucking be, and then also through that inspire people. I want to be like, me and Bobby talk about this all the time, we want to be something different. Like, we want to take aspects,
yeah, bring
like,
something from, new to the table
from,
man.
All like, there's so much like just oversaturated bullshit in the fitness industry today, and it's like we want to take aspects of everything. Like, I feel like there's almost this kind of divide, like between, like, because you have the new era and you have like these aesthetics guys, like,
yeah,
like Lex, like Anthony, you know, David Lade, Dylan, like all these guys, is like, and they're kind of looked down upon, and it's like they don't really deserve that, because like you see the amount of work, like, that they're putting, yeah, in. Many of them are strong as shit.
They are.
Like, we want the perfect blend of like old school and new school. Like, yeah, we want that aesthetics.
Quite frankly, I don't even know what I want, as far as I want to bring something new to the table, because right now
be something different. It's like
the new thing trending is strength.
Right,
crazy strength and aesthetics at the same time.
I'm glad that's a new trend, because like that's what we want to do.
Me too. But at the same time, we got to top that, and right. I don't even know how yet. It'll come to us at some point.
It's like, yeah, do we want to be that, like the David Lade kind of figure physique? Like, not necessarily that I want specifically a physique like David Lade's, but you get the point. But like, obviously, I still want to look aesthetic. I want to have a bodybuilder physique, but I want to fucking train like Dorian Yates.
Right,
I want to train like Dan Green. I want to be as strong as Dan Green. Like, yeah. I'm saying, I think like taking those two disciplines, like that's an even bigger challenge and a bigger discipline to be able to accomplish that. And like, I'm up for the challenge.
Right. And that's something we've also talked about, is if you look in any of our videos, it's not us being at our prettiest state. It's not us in the best lighting at all times. Like, we wanted to bring it to training more than the camera.
Like, I will say, like, a lot of people, it's about the camera sometimes now. And then sometimes, like, I would say, like, you haven't even seen anything from us yet of how hard we can fucking train. You've seen nothing.
And you, even the things that you have seen, you've only saw one set of each exercise. You know, you haven't saw the ones that we busted ass on, you know, that we needed a spotter just to, like, basically, you haven't really seen anything from us. And just like what I was saying is, you just haven't seen anything as far as like how far we push ourselves.
How far we're going to push ourselves. So basically, like, I've kind of been trying to come up with a game plan for the upcoming weeks and months, because I've noticed, just kind of like looking over all my physique or my lifts and stuff, and like, I've noticed like where I do have weaknesses. I am bulking right now, which is probably why I look a little bit watery and flabby. I want to get more disciplined with my diet, more disciplined with my bulking. I'm going to continue to bulk, into summer, and then I'm going to do like a shortcut, 6 to 8 weeks, nothing too crazy. And then from there, like, do a re-bulk from there after I cut back down, because I think that'll kind of give my body time to reset, and then if I go back into bulking again, it'll accelerate that process. So for today on the schedule, it's week one, day one. I'm just going to be doing some shoulder press, a few different sets. Top sets, 5 sets of 3 at 70%. I'm going to be going in full intensity to this program. Bobby, he knows his body. He's kind of been dealing with just kind of some nagging, not like anything too serious, just some nagging injuries. I just got to
focus on some hypertrophy for a little bit. Slack off so a little bit.
I wouldn't say slacking off.
Yeah, no, I just need to take a break and not be an idiot like I am right. A lot. I try to push it way too far.
But you guys are going to see me go full on into this. So we've got shoulder press and then just a couple back accessories, barbell row, 4 sets of 10, side lateral, 4 sets of 10, lat pull down, 4 sets of 10. Really simple. Get it out of the way. I mean, in and out. This is, like I said, hypertrophy. So I'm really excited to bring this to you guys. I want to be much more real and raw and, like, let you guys get to know me as my channel is growing, so you can actually feel like you're personally connected with my journey. My plan is, because I know I mentioned I was going to do a cut this summer. My plan is I'm going to do this 12-week program, maybe possibly take a week off or so after that, because it's supposed to lead up where you're actually leading up to a meet. I'm not doing a meet, but I am going to be hitting a max out of my lifts. And then I'm wanting to find, I may have a good buddy of mine, Judah, which you've seen in our other videos. I may have him design a hypertrophy program for me. I may find one somewhere else. Whatever it is, I want to do a 6-week really, really intense, just straight bodybuilding hypertrophy bulking program after this powerlifting one. Really maximize my hypertrophy and bulking before I do my cut. So that's the game plan, guys. It's, let's see what time it is. I've been talking for a while. I'm going to wrap this up. We're going to get inside. We're at crunch day. It looks pretty. It's not necessarily ideal for the intensity.
But for the videos, man.
But for the videos, it looks good. Hopefully, we're going to be training over at Buckeye again soon. We'll see about that. But I'm going to shut up. We're going to get into the workout. We'll see you guys in there.
Get it. Easy weight. Easy.
I think it's a good weight for 5 sets of 3.
Yeah. Let's get it, man.
How much shorter are you racking
it? Yeah, it's really hard re-racking it. I always feel like I'm gonna screw it up. All right.
a bodybuilding workout, which I think is what we both needed, very much so. We will definitely get into the intense, heavy, crazy, Dorian Yates style.
For sure.
Lifting heavy, even powerlifting as the program progresses. But for right now, the first couple of weeks is about building up a bit of hypertrophy. You notice, like, all of our reps were very slow, very controlled, really focusing on the squeeze, on the contraction of the muscle. That was a very fun workout. Got some good footage. I'm really excited to, I think this is going to really help us get on like a really specific set schedule. I'm busting these videos out for you guys. Just having a systematic program to stick with. And I'm gonna be doing like these kind of outros probably after every video. I want to get this as detailed as I can of like what the results I'm making, the weights I'm hitting, all that stuff, getting the posing footage, because like I said, even in the beginning of this video, we're not just going for powerlifting to be as strong as we possibly can. We're also training to look good, both disciplines. Obviously, I will say we both suck at posing. Posing is an art. Tomorrow's video will be the concert vlog for the Fit for a King concert. Hopefully everything goes through with that and there isn't any more coronavirus bullshit.
Exactly.
Depending on how much of shit we get beat out of us in the mosh pit, hopefully we'll do the second day of the program, which is deadlifts. Hopefully we'll do that Friday. And then that should be up either that day or maybe the next day for you guys.
You'll do deadlifts, I won't be.
You won't be doing deadlifts, I will be though. It's been a while since I did deadlifts. I'm really excited to get back to them. But thank you guys so much for watching. Like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe, hit the notifications bell, all that good stuff. Big huge favor, share to help the channel grow. If you know somebody that will also enjoy the video, share it with them. But yeah, we're out. Time's up.